Today, what we're looking at here is a 428 cubic inch Windsor, twin turbocharged. Done some really neat stuff with it. We've made this kind of alien intake for it, but went ahead and have the intercooler sandwiched in between the runners. You can kind of see where the water flows in and out of the intake manifold there. We've got a really cool, this is going in a 32 roadster. So this is a really cool exhaust system. It's a 2.5 inch wastegate pipe on a 60 millimeter tile gate, and then a 3.5 inch exhaust pipe above it, with of course our stainless headers. And you can see how we kind of laid it all out. Everything flows. Even these welds, if you want to look at it, even we've made it to where all these welds line up. Really a visual and artistic deal. But since the car is going to run through mufflers, we went ahead and put a pipe in here to go through the actual mufflers. And then inside of here, we've got a removable plug to be able to block off the outlet when he doesn't want to be crazy. It's got air conditioning and alternator, all the goodies. Rudy over here did a nice job on all these stainless hard lines. You can kind of see how all of them flow, and it just tidies up the whole package. Kind of how it goes over the reg bodies and some of our fabricated covers. And build qualities, they're just getting better and better and better. I mean, even down to this throttle bracket here. I mean, we've pretty much, it's not polished or anything, but you can really get an idea of the attention to detail that's happening here. It's just crazy looking. And what's really kind of a sexy view of it is, of course, we have the mirror image turbos on it, but doesn't go to an intercooler in the front. It just plumbs in, and the intercooler sandwiched into the intake, and that makes it look real slick. These mirror image turbos, they give you such a big envelope to make things look symmetrical, and it just helps the design of the whole engine bay. It just drastically changes everything. Okay, so here is a shot of the Windsor at 10 pounds boost, 832 foot-pounds of torque, 818 horsepower at 5,800. And you can see just how fat that curve is. It's 746 at 3,500, 818. And it's pretty cool because it's an option for somebody who doesn't have any room for an intercooler forward. In this 32, there was just zero room. All you had is room for a radiator. So, any rate, it is an option, and is making pretty good power. And I love the look of this thing. At 19 pounds of boost, 1,181 foot-pounds of torque, 1,142 horsepower, and climbing at 6,000 RPM.
Good air fuel ratios, looking nice. And just going in a 32, fucking, it's gonna be a wild ride. The car's name is Psycho, and this thing is definitely Psycho. Another 16 pounds of boost if he wants it, but really, I don't think he'll ever need it.